So as Ghana's democracy matures, civil society organizations have become a crucial element to deepening local governance and activism, and have seen an upsurge since the late 90s on our InFocus tonight. Viasat One News' video journalist in Takoradi, Kwesi Ejienim, takes a look at the contribution of civil society organizations in sharpening transparency and local participation within the Shama district.
Transparency and local participation have been identified as the pivot around which the local governance system is expected to thrive. However, inadequate government funding to sensitize locals on participation in local governance and also push for transparency has led to donor agencies such as the Oxfam, USAID, GIZ, among others, as well as foreign governments, to rather provide funding for civil society organizations, CSOs, to push for local participation and transparency at the local levels. This has led to the upsurge in the numbers of CSOs across the country, with the Western region alone having over 100 CSOs. The Economic Planning Officer of the Western region believes CSOs are advancing local governance.
We have the public sector and then the private sector. And in the new governance system, our democratic dispensation, we need a body or a third force that will regulate the activities of the public sector, especially talking about advocacy, advocating for policy change. And the NGOs and civil societies play a very useful role in that because they are not directly under government influence.
Friends of the Nation, a Sekendi-based CSO, is a leader in local governance advocacy in the Western region and is currently pushing the frontiers of local governance within the Shama district.
Yes, our interest is to facilitate the increase of transparency and also accountability, especially the utilization of public resources, and also stimulate citizens to self-mobilize and engage local government authorities to demand accountability. So for example, in Shama district, we supported them to develop their medium-term plan through rigorous participatory process. We targeted over 3,000 people in 34 communities. So right now, through this initiative, we have engaged over 3,000 people through town hall meetings to people's forum. We have also trained about 30 state and non-state actors to use social accountability tools such as public expenditure tracking survey.
But how has this participation and transparency advocacies advanced the cause of the Shama district?
Our people, they have the right to know how their resources are being spent. And that is where the civil society organizations, their role is very, very important. They helped us, the assemblies, to bring local governance closer to the people. They help us to also account to the people. As I'm talking to you now, Shama District Assembly, for example, we've come up with a novelty, and we did it with Friends of the Nation. In the year 2015 alone, we had 7 different engagements with our community leaders and the community people in general. We call it the People's Assembly, where we give them feedback about the various development projects and how far we've been able to implement it. We take their feedback, and it also informs our decisions further.
Jeffrey Scott, who is the planning officer for the Shama district, provides hard fact of CSO's benefits in revenue mobilization.
In the first quarter of 2015, our revenue was 67.23%. 67.23%. But in the same quarter of 2016, our revenue has shot up to a whopping 91.4%. That emphasizes the impact or the importance and significance of CSO engagement in our communities.
An assembly member and a queen mother, all from the Shama district, say CSOs have given them a voice.
There's one particular community where there has been a lot of always a problem with vehicles moving here and there. And so there was the need for us to have a speed ramp. This came up when the civil society organization, for example, the Friends of the Nation, took it up in one of the public forums, they raised it that the community, per the assessment they have done, they have been crying and calling for speed ramps. And I can tell you for a fact, ever since that issue was brought up to the assembly and we also added our voice to it as assembly members, we now have that facility fixed. It is there for the people. And so the problems we were facing previously is no more.
Because the civil societies have sensitized the people to come out boldly, not to fear, but whatever is bothering them, they should feel free to come out and say. And through that, now we have projects going on. Some have even been completed.
In measuring the contribution of civil societies in the area of promotion of participatory democracy as well as transparency at the local level, I have come to the Shama Junction Market, which is said to be a beneficiary of this particular concept of promoting grassroots participation and transparency.
They are a friend of the nation. Anyone can say, we share here in a meeting.
Friends of the Nation gave us the opportunity to meet with the district assembly officials to lay out our problems, which included lack of lighting at the market, security at the market, and access road. Thankfully, the market light problem has been solved, but we are waiting for the rest.
Reporting for Basatwa News, I am Kwesi Ejenim, Shama.